Welcome to the Thread to Mend podcast. My name is Taylor, coming to you from Baltimore, Maryland. And in this week's episode, I'm just going to show you how I use my hand combs. These are a set of extra fine double row combs. I think that they're about 4 inches, maybe five. Can't remember which ones I purchased, but these here I have clamped to my table with a couple C-clamps that I bought at the hardware store around the corner. And this is a bit of the Cormo cross with merino fleece purchased at the 2017 Rhinebeck Sheep and Wool Festival, or New York State Sheep and Wool Festival. This is fiber that, because it's a Cormo crossed with merino, it was mostly dark, and so I separated the light and the dark. So as I pick the fleece out of my basket here to load my comb, I'm pulling it from the tip end, and I'm trying to get as much tip together as I can, and it'll separate into a little bunch here. And I'll look over the fiber and make sure that I don't have any dark mixed in, and I'll just separate that as I come. Ooh, comb in my... These combs can be a little scary at first because they're sharp and long and have a fair bit of weight. So you want to be mindful not to impale your chest on your combs. But even if you do a little bit, you know, you just stretch it back out. So once you find the tip end from the cut end, you'll just slide your fiber over the very tip of the comb. And you want to not pull too much behind, just enough to catch it. And then you'll build a row across. This is as much as you probably want to add to a comb of this size because it can become a little tough on your wrists. You see here, there's just a speck of dark fleece I want to pull out there. So I'm going to start doing my first pass. This can be a little dirty because this is where the VM, the vegetable matter, will fall out of your fleece. So I kind of sit to the side, but if you're sitting close and maybe you don't want to get messy, you could put an apron on for this task. So one thing to make this job a little easier is to pick the ends open. This fleece is one of the cleanest I've bought, and this had a little canarying, that yellow color, to it, which didn't wash out in the entire fleece. It will blend with the rest of it and just make it a little bit off-white of a color. It won't be as yellow as you see there. It's amazing how combing out the fibers together really blends any irregularity. So this is more flicking open than I typically do, but it will make this process a lot quicker and easier. And this is where you might notice a fleece might be a bit tippy, as they call it, and that's when the tips break off. This Cormo fiber over here in this basket that I've dyed with pokeberry is a little tippy like that. I'll just show you really quick that I could probably just pick the end off of that fiber. And that's a bit of the waste. So it makes the process of preparing your fiber for spinning a little bit more laborious, but it's not a deal breaker. It's probably in this instance for this fleece, it was like the one thing that was not amazing, but it wasn't a huge strike against it. So you'll find when you're buying a fleece, some things that you can live with and some things that maybe you don't want to. So I'm going to start passing this fiber from this comb to this one by just doing a few light strokes. And I might start at the bottom to begin. I use this outside of my hand against the front of these tines just to give a little more stability to the pole. Because this is the first pass, it's the one that's going to require the most amount of effort from your wrists or your forearms through the process. And notice that I am pulling the comb towards me, but not into my face. So I picked up a little too much fiber here, and it's hard to pull off, so I'm going to come back and try a little less. And now I might switch the direction of my comb and do it away from me. Whenever I pick up fiber like this, right, obviously I didn't get the tips onto the comb well enough. I might have missed a spot where it didn't grab I'll just put it back on. I'm having a little bit of static cling because it is winter and the air is somewhat dry. And I don't worry about it so much on the first pass, but I will use my hand to smooth it in the right direction again. So notice that I'm going towards me, but not towards my face. That slight angle gives me more leverage also, so there's really no reason you should be doing that. It gives me more leverage to pull down. Now I have this hooked to a table that is not the sturdiest. It's probably one of the least sturdiest tables of my home. And so that's why I'm using a little leverage of my left hand to stabilize it. But if you're using this on a major table, you might not have this need, that left hand, and you can maybe manipulate the fiber better. So you know, bringing the outside of my hand to the front of the tines, I can smooth the fiber and use that resistance. So after I've gone in one direction for a little while, I'll turn and go in the other. And the first pass always takes the most amount of time. With this fleece and other fleeces, I've only done two passes. That's because it's rather clean. I don't have a lot of VM to get out. And it just seems to work out that way. You can do as many as like six passes. I don't think there's any rules to it. But the more that I have found that the more I manipulate the fiber, the more opportunities I give for any one of these threads to kind of curl, not curl, but fall back on itself and become twisted. And that will create very, very tiny knots of a fiber in your combed out. Now this is one task I don't do with my dog on my lap, so you might hear her walking and begging, but it's just not safe. Her eyes would probably be at the level of my hand, so you want to definitely put your pets down for this task, even if they don't want you to. Right till I get to this end here, I keep going, I keep passing it over. I might be able to pick little tiny sort of nubs out as I go because I don't want them to transfer into my hand comb. And when I get about this little, just enough that I could pull it off, I just yank it off manually with my hand by wiggling it right and left, and I'll draft it as I go. Get a little twist to remain steady. And then I'll hold on to this. I'll just set that aside. And then this is waste, so I'll tuck this away in a little basket here. I'm going to start passing the fiber back onto my first comb. And I might just pick out any bits that I don't want to add in there. Right at the first beginning, you can see that there is this part that didn't get combed out as much as the rest. I'll just try to get a close-up on that. So I'm going to go over that first and just make sure that that gets out. And then I might go back over it one time just with that spot. So I'm doing a little bit of a spot treatment to the comb. You might do that one or two times, but it's not often that it's needed as you comb back onto the table. So you want to be mindful of the direction you're holding the cones as you pull towards yourself. And as I move, it's easier on the second time, putting it back on the cones, to smooth it down as you pull back. Thank you. do that. Sometimes I'll nick the corner of my tines also. I'll do the same thing again. And this time around, you're gonna see there's a little bit of nubs there. So I'm gonna maybe not save the very end of that. Because if you remember, when I transferred the fiber from here onto here, it was the tips of the fiber that landed on this comb. And the tips are gonna be a little more damaged and a little messier than the beginning. So you notice I had a very little amount of waste on this comb, but on this one, I might have a little more. I'm just gonna mix here this reserve, the first one. I might do another tug of what's left over. Just looking out for any neps or noils or whichever of the two they are. And I'm gonna put this on here, and I'm just gonna hand place it with the rest of the fiber. So it's kind of blended in. And I think that being this conservative with the fiber, maybe it'll give it, I wouldn't say it'll work, make it less worsted, but it's possible that a few strands get folded on themselves. I noticed that when I'm spinning the areas that were this part of the fleece, as I combed it, there's one black hair here I'm gonna tug out. It's a little more worsted prep. I'm sorry, it was a little more woolen prep. It's amazing how hard it is to pull the correct word out when you know it matters. Woolen prep, sometimes. It feels a little more woolen when I'm spinning that part of it. But I try to blend it as I draft. So next I'm just gonna fluff this out, make it a little bigger, take up the space of the comb. You might find a little area to prep. And then I'm gonna grab a corner, and I'm stabilizing my table with my shin a little bit. I'm gonna draft back. And as I draft, I just give it a twist each time I change my hand position to give it a little stability in the fiber. And I'm trying to maintain a consistent girth of the fiber in hand. So each time I transition, I'm pinching off a little bit of this cloud. I find it easier to pull from one corner towards the others rather than all of it at once from the tip. I want to make sure too that as I draft that I'm not letting my fiber touch the floor because I do have pets with hair. It's okay if you pull off a little more than maybe you were previously. You do want to try to blend the transition of space, so continuously gathering the tips to pull back. disconnect from the chunk of fiber, I'll just place it back on the comb gently, continue to draft from the supply. I always want to try to not let my hand slip off the grip of the fiber because it's going to pull the fiber out of the direction. So I want to try to be careful that I can grip onto all sides as well as the center of what I'm drafting off the comb so the hand doesn't slip. So I'll just take the waste off. So you can save to stuff a pillow or comb into a bat if you want to make very textured yarn. And I'm going to take the end of what I drafted and I'm just going to very loosely wrap it around my fingers, gently twisting it so that it remains a little separate from the rest. Little bit of debris from my lap. Single black fiber there. All right, and I have a perfect little cloud of fiber to spin. So I'll tuck this away in another space. I have a shelf right behind me. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video and ignoring my weird hair throughout that recording, which distracted me throughout editing. You can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Taylor E. Owen. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below this video here on YouTube. I always look forward to hearing from you and sharing in this community.